Hello students, how are you? I hope all of you are fine. So student, in the previous part of the video, we are solving exercise 3.5 and in that part, we have covered the second part of question number 4. And I also told you that whatever questions are remaining, I will discuss in the next video. So here, the next part of question number 4 is that word problem, that is Yash scored 40 marks in a test, getting 3 marks for each right answer and losing 1 marks for each wrong answer. Okay? Had 4 marks been awarded for each correct answer and 2 marks be deducted for each incorrect answer, then Yash would have scored 50 marks. How many questions were there in the test? Okay, so there is a boy Yash who is appearing in a test, and in that test he have corrected some question and he have wrong some question. Okay, so we have to find total number of questions. Now student, you tell me how to calculate total number of questions. Suppose in the test there is 30 questions. Okay, so you have attempted 20, you have correct 20 and 10 you have done wrong. So 20 plus 10 is equal to 30 comes now. Similarly, if you want to calculate the total number of questions in a test, what you will do? You will add number of correct question plus number of incorrect question. Okay, so we will solve this. First, what we'll assume? Suppose Yash is a boy, na? So he have corrected some question and he have incorrected some questions. Okay, so what we will assume? We will assume let correct answer he has given, that is x, sorry, not correct answer, number of correct answer. Okay, let number of correct answer is x and number of incorrect answer, that is y. So what will be the total number of questions? So total number of questions will be x plus y means number of corrected plus number of incorrected. Okay, so now Yash scored how many marks? 40 marks in a test, getting 3 marks for each correct answer. Suppose he have done 5 correct answer. Okay, so for one correct answer he is getting 3 marks. So 5 correct answer he will get, 3 into 5, 15 marks. And suppose he has done 2 incorrect answer. So for 2 incorrect answer, losing 1 marks for each correct incorrect answer. So if he will do 2 incorrect, so how many marks will be deducted? 2 into 1, that is 2. So what will be the total marks he will achieve? He will achieve 15 minus 2, that is 13. Because whatever answer he will incorrect, that marks will be deducted from the correct answer. Are you getting? Suppose there is a minus marking exam, and suppose out of 20 questions, there are 10 questions which he have corrected and 10 questions he has incorrected. So for corrected he will get 10 into 3, that is 30, and for incorrected he will deduct 10 into 1, that is 10. So whatever marks he will get, so 30 minus 10, that is 20. Because when he will do wrong, there is a negative marking. So whatever incorrect he will do, that much marks deducted from his marks. Okay, so what will be the R method? So what we will do, see, 3 marks for each right answer. So for each right answer, because number of correct answer is x, so if number of correct answer is x, so number of marks of correct answer will be 3x, because for one correct answer there is 3 marks. So for x correct answer there will be 3x marks. Similarly, for one incorrect answer there is y, sorry, for every incorrect answer there will be losing 1 marks. So if there are y number of incorrect answer, so that will be y into 1, and because it is deducting, so its sign will be negative. So what he will do, see, according to the question we will get 3 into x, okay, 3 into x, because number of correct answer was x, so for getting each correct he is getting 3 marks, so 3 into x. Now plus for incorrect answer he is losing 1 marks, so losing 1 marks, so because here is loss, so we will take negative minus 1 into number of incorrect answer is y. So when that much you will do, he is getting how much marks? 40. Okay, so our equation will be 3x minus y equal to 40. Okay, I hope you have understood. For correct answer he is getting plus 3 and for incorrect answer he is getting minus 1. Okay, so 3 into x plus minus 1 into y, which both will be added, he will get 40 marks. Now in the second case, had 4 marks been awarded, means when for correct answer 4 marks is awarded and 2 marks is deducted from each incorrect answer. Okay, so when 4 marks is awarded for x number of questions, so 4x, because 4 into x, because x was number of correct answer, plus 2 marks is deducted from each incorrect answer, so because deducted, so minus 2 into y, so when that much will be done, he is getting 50 marks. So what will be the equation? 4x minus 2y equal to 50. Now this is our equation number 1, this is our equation number 2. Now we have to solve these two equations, so any of the method you can use. So I am using elimination method. So see, I want to remove either x or y, so I will remove y. So what I will do, I will see the coefficient of y in both the equation, here is 1 or here is 2. So what I will do, I will multiply equation 1 by 2 and I will multiply equation 2 by 1 only, because when 1 is multiplied to any number, number will remain same. So when 2 is multiplied to equation number 1, we will get 6x minus 2y equal to 80, and when 1 is multiplied to equation number 2, we will get 4x minus 2y equal to 50. Now solve it, because both y have a same sign, so subtraction will be there, so minus plus minus, this will be cancelled. Now 2x equal to 30, so x will be equal to 30 by 2, that is 15. So you got the value of x, now put in any equation so that you can get the value of y. So from equation 1, I can say 3 into 15 minus y equal to 40. Now 45 minus y equal to 40, so 45 minus 40 equal to y, so y equal to 5. So now in the by solving these two equations, we got the value of x and y. And now what was x? X was number of correct answer, so it means that he have corrected 15 questions, okay, and he had incorrected 5 questions. So how many total number of questions will be there in the table? So total questions will be equal to x plus y, that is corrected plus incorrected. So x is 15 and y is 5. So answer will be 20. So in the test, there will be 20 questions. Okay? I'm going to repeat this method again. See, whenever you will give any examination which has negative marking, so for every correct answer you will get something, and for every incorrect answer your marks will be deducted. So in this question, Yash scored 40 marks, and when he is getting 40 marks, so in that case he got 3 marks for correct answer, for each correct answer, means if he will correct 1, so he will get 3, if he will correct 2, he will get 6, and so on. And he will lose 1 mark for each wrong answer. So in the starting, what I have assumed? I have assumed number of correct answer is x and number of incorrect answer is y. So total number of question x plus y, that is corrected plus incorrected. After that, we have seen that he scored 40 marks, and in that 40 marks, he was getting 3 marks for correct answer and losing 1 marks for wrong answer. So correct answer was x, so suppose he has corrected x answer, so 3 into x, because he is getting that much point, so that is positive, and here he is losing 1 marks, so when whenever you will loss, there will be negative sign. So minus 1 into number of incorrect question. When both will be solved, which is equal to 40. Okay, same thing we have applied for the second case also. After that we got two equations. We have solved by the elimination method also. So after that we got the value of x is equal to 15 and the value of y equal to 5. And in the end, we got the total number of question, that is 15 plus 5 is equal to 20. So this is your method. Student, please note down it. So I hope you have understood this question. So I am moving fourth part of question number 4. Okay, this is a very simple question. This is a basic concept. When you will understand the negative marking concept, you will able to solve this question. Okay, because question was asking total number of questions, so total number of question was 20. Okay, now fourth part. Student, I am not writing the question because it takes space. Okay, and it takes time also. So I hope you all having a book. Now, fourth part of question number 4. Places A and B are 100 km apart on a highway. Suppose there are places A and B. Suppose here is A and B, and they are 100 km apart, means they are 100 km away from each other. Okay, now one car starts from A and another from B at the same time, means from these two point one car is starts from that same time. Okay, if car travel in the same direction at different speed, means both car having different speed, okay, they meet in 5 hour. After that, if they travel towards each other, they meet in 1 hour. What are the speed of two cars? Now listen, student, what is question saying? Question is saying that there are two points, that is A and B, and which are 100 km apart from each other, means the distance between these two points are 100 km. Okay, now at the same time one car is moving from here also and one car is moving from here also. Okay, suppose it is a car. My drawing is not very good, so you can understand. Okay, so at the same time two cars have started and their speed is also different. Okay, so let this speed is x and his speed is y. Okay, so there are two cases, when they will move in the same direction and when they will move in the opposite direction. So I am solving this question one by one. Now see, what we will assume, let the speed of car at point A is x kilometer per hour, and speed of car at point B equal to y kilometer per hour, because both has different speed, that's why I have assumed x of this car and y of this car. So there are two conditions. The first condition is that when they will move in same direction, they meet in 5 hours. So when this, suppose it is the first condition, A, B, one car is moving from this point in this direction and another car is also moving from point B in this direction. Okay, same direction, means it is going also in this direction and it is also going in this direction. So after 5 hours they will meet. So suppose in 5 hours this car will also travel a certain distance and this car will also travel a certain distance. So suppose when they will move in this direction, they will meet outside their distances, means suppose they will meet here. this point they will meet. At point P they will meet. So what I am writing, suppose they will meet at point P. Okay, so when they will move it at point P, so this car will also be at that point and this car will also be at that point. So suppose how much distance covered by a car from point A. So this is the distance now, from here to here, that much distance the car will cover from point A in 5 hours. So suppose, student, you have studied the concept of distance, time and speed. Distance is equal to speed into time, you all know na? And this AP is the distance of car traveled by a car in 5 hours. So the distance of car traveled, the distance of car at point P in 5 hours. Okay, distance covered by car from point A in 5 hours. Why in 5 hours? Because they meet in 5 hours. That will be AP na? That will be the distance AP. And we all know distance is equal to speed into time. We know that distance is equal to speed into time. So we can write distance is equal to speed into time. So in 5 hours, the car from point A will cover how much distance? That is, speed was x and time was 5. It means 5x. It is clear or not? Because the speed of this car is x and in 5 hours it will cover 5x kilometer. Okay, now distance covered by car B in 5 hours, that will be your BP. This car will cover this much distance now. So BP will be equal to, again, speed into time. Its speed is y and time is 5. So it means 5y. So now, student, by this car the distance covered is AP and by this car the distance covered is BP. So see, if we subtract AP minus BP, so what will be the value, student? If we will subtract AP minus BP, so what will be the distance? So AP minus BP, which will be equal to AB. And what is the distance of AB? The distance of AB was 100 kilometers. See, 100 kilometers. So I can write 5x minus 5y equal to 100. Now, take 5 as common. So 5x minus y equal to 100. So x minus y equal to 100 by 5. So x minus y equal to 20. So this is your equation number 1. Okay, because they are moving in the same direction na? So they will meet outside these two points. Okay, because it is also going in this direction and it is also going in this direction. So first we have calculated the distance covered by a car from point A, that will be your AP, and that is 5x. Same thing we have done for point B, and that is BP is equal to 5y. And in the end we subtracted AP minus BP, which will be equal to AB. And AB was 100, so 5x minus 5y equal to 100, so x minus y equal to 20. This is your equation number 1, and this is your first condition also. Okay, note down, student. First condition was that because they were moving in the same direction. Okay, so first equation we got x minus y equal to 20. Now second condition, why I am using this image diagram, because you will understand more. In second condition, they are moving in opposite direction, so if they are moving in the opposite direction, student, see, it is A and it is B. One car is moving in this direction and other car will moving in this direction. So between them they will meet now. Between A, B, they will meet at some point. So suppose they will meet at this point, point P, in second condition. So in second condition means opposite direction. First condition was same direction and second condition is opposite direction. So suppose they will meet at point P. So the distance covered by first car, when they will move in the opposite direction, they will meet in 1 hour. So means in 1 hour this car will also make some distance and this car will also make some distance. So the distance covered by a car from point A, so distance covered by car from point A in 1 hour, because 1 hour they are meeting now. So again that will be your AP, and in this case AP is speed into time, because distance is equal to speed into time. So speed is x and time is 1, so it is come x. Now same thing we will do for car B also. So distance covered by car from point B in 1 hour, that is BP, because it is going in this direction, BP. Okay, and BP is equal to speed into time. Speed is y and time is 1, it is y. So again you are seeing the value of AP comes x and the value of BP comes y. Suppose the student, when we will add AP plus BP we will get AB. So we can say now AP plus BP is equal to AB. AP was x, BP was y, which is equal to 100. So it is your equation number 2. So equation 1 was what is x minus y equal to 20. This was our equation number 1 and this is our equation number 2. Okay, so now both two equations can be solved by any method. So I am using elimination method. So from equation 1 and 2, x minus y equal to 20 and x plus y equal to 100. If I will use elimination method, so it is very easy. See, both x are also having the same coefficient, both y also having the same coefficient. So if we want to eliminate y, then it will be easy for us. So because both y having the same sign, both y having an opposite sign, so both equation will be added, and in case of addition there will not any change in the sign. So this y we cancel, it will come 2x and it will come 120. So x is equal to 120 by 2, it means 60. Now you got the value of x. So from equation 1, x minus y equal to 20, so 60 minus y equal to 20, so y equal to 60 minus 20 means 40. So both car speed we got, the first car speed was x, the second car speed was y. So x equal to 60 km per hour and y equal to 40 km per hour. Okay, now you can see now both cars having the different speed. One car speed is 60 and the other car speed is 40. Okay, so by this way you can solve. Basically this is the question of physics. Okay, and because we have used the concept of distance, time and speed, so by this we can solve that type of question. Nothing we have done, very easy concept. First you will assume the speed of both the two cars. Suppose one car is starting from this point and another car is starting from this point at the same time. In first condition they are moving in the same direction, so they will meet outside the point between them, so they will meet here. So after that, we will cover the distance covered by the first car in 5 hours, and same the distance covered by a car in second. Sorry, the distance covered by the second car in 5 hours. After that, we have subtracted AP minus BP, which is equal to 100. We solved. Then we got X minus Y equal to 20. Now, in the second case, both are traveling in the opposite direction. So when they are traveling in the opposite direction, they will meet between them any point. So let the point is P. So again, we have calculated the distance covered by a car from point A in 1 hour. That is speed into time. That is X. And in second case, it comes Y. And we saw that AP plus BP was 100. So we have added. So X plus Y equal to 100. Now we got the two equation. We have solved by the elimination method. And after that, we got the value of X and Y, which is equal to 60 and 40. So both car having the speed of 60 km per hour and 40 km per hour. Okay. So please note down this. So by this way, student, you can solve this type of question. It is very important question and it also comes in the exam. Okay. So I hope you have noted down. So let's move to the last question of exercise 3.5. This one is very simple, student. When you will solve now, then you will realize. Now, fifth part of question number four. The area of a triangle gets reduced by 9 square unit if length is reduced by 5 unit and breadth is increased by 3 units. Okay, we all know that the area of the triangle is length into breadth. So we have to assume length is X and breadth is area of the triangle get reduced by 9 means whatever area was there, it will be 9 less. Okay. When length is reduced by 5 and breadth is increased by 3. Okay. Second condition, if we increase the length by 3 units and the breadth by 2 units, the area increases by 67. Find the dimension of the rectangle. So what we will assume? Let length of the rectangle is X and breadth of rectangle is Y. So what will be the area, student? Area is equal to length into breadth. Area is equal to length into breadth. So X into Y, that is your area. Now according to the question, area of the rectangle reduced by 9. When? So when the length is reduced by 5 and breadth is increased by 3. So see, when length will decrease by 5, so new length will be what? New length will be X minus 5 and new breadth will be Y plus 3, because length is decreasing, breadth is increasing. So in this case, what will be the new area? So your new area will be X minus 5 into Y plus 3. This is your new area, student. Okay? Because when length is decreased and breadth is increased, you will get new area. So new area will be X minus 5 into Y plus 3. But what question is saying? Area of the rectangle reduced by 9. Means this area will reduced by 9 when this much happened. So what we will do, new area will be equal to, because new area is that, so new area is equal to the original area minus how much? 9. So original area was xy minus 9. So the value of this area is equal to the original area minus 9. Means when this happens, whatever area we are getting, it is less than 9 from the original. Okay, and original was X into Y. So now put the value of new area. New area is X minus 5 into y plus 3 is equal to x minus 9. Now when you will solve it, you will get xy minus 5y plus 3x minus 15 is equal to xy minus 9. Now xy cancel. Now it can be written as 3x minus 5y. I have written in order, and when this will transfer from this side to this side, it will become minus 9 plus 15. So 3x minus 5y equal to 6. This is equation number 1. Okay, I am again saying, first we have assumed length and breadth, that is x and y, and we have calculated area, that is x into y. Now condition is that area reduced by 9. Area reduced by 9 means when this happened, when length decreased by 5, it means x minus 5. When breadth decreased by increased by 3, that is y plus 3. So you will get some area. So this area is 9 less than the original area. So original area was xy. So xy minus 9 equal to new area. Now second case, length is also increasing and breadth is also increasing. So now new length will become how much? Length is increasing by 3 units, so it will become x plus 3, and new breadth will become y plus 2. So in this case, new area how much will come? New area will be x plus 3 into y plus 2. This is your new area, because length into breadth is the area of rectangle. So now new length is x plus 3, new breadth is y plus 2. So new area will be x plus 3 and y plus 2. So student, question is saying that when this happens, whatever area we are getting is 67 more than the original area. It means new area is equal to original area, that is xy plus 60 and y plus 2 is equal to xy plus 67. Now solve it. So it will come xy plus 3y plus 2x plus 6 equal to xy plus 67. Now xy cancel. So I got 2x plus 3y, and I am transferring this 6 to this side. So 67 minus 6, I got 2x plus 3y equal to 61. This is our equation number 2. Okay, some calculation mistake was there, so sorry for that. Now equation 1 is this, equation 2 is this, and both equation don't have the same coefficient of x and y. So we will multiply by a suitable number so that we can eliminate either x or either y. So I am eliminating x. So for eliminating x, I will multiply equation 1 by 2 and equation 2 by 3. So when I will do that, I will get 6x minus 10y equal to 12. And second equation, 6x minus plus 9y equal to 183. Okay. So now both x having the same sign, so we will subtract. So when we will subtract, we will get minus minus minus. So it will be cancelled. So minus 10y and minus 9y equal to minus 19y. And this is 182 minus 12. How much? Minus 171. So minus minus cancel. So y equal to 171 upon 19. That is 9. Okay. So by solving these two equations, we got the value of y. So I hope you have noted down this part. So I am erasing. Now student, we got the value of y now. So you can put the value of y in any of the one equation. So from equation 1, I can say 3x minus 5y equal to 6. Put the value of y here. So 3x minus 5 into 9 equal to 6. So 3x minus 45 equal to 6. So 3x equal to 6 plus 45. So 3x equal to 51. So x equal to 51 by 3, that is 17. So x was length and y was length, and both we have calculated. The value of x comes 17 and the value of y comes 9. So the length will be x, that is 17 unit, and breadth was y, that is 9 units. Okay, so that is our final answer. Okay, so I hope you have understood what we have done from the starting. We have assumed the dimension of rectangle, that is length is x, breadth is y. So we have calculated area, that is length into breadth, x into y. After that, question said ki if length is reduced by 5 and breadth is increased by 3, so length will become x minus 5 and breadth will become y plus 3. So in this case you will get new area, and this area is 9 less than the original area. So we had found this condition. So after solving, we got this equation. Now second condition, length was also increasing by 3 units, so that is new length is x plus 3, and breadth is also increasing, so breadth was y plus 2. After that we have calculated area, so new area was x plus 3 and y plus 2. So this area is 67 more than the original area, so new area will become xy plus 67. After solving, we got the second equation, and after getting two equations, we have solved them by the help of elimination method, so that we got the value of x equal to 17 and got the value of y equal to 9, which are the dimensions of the rectangle. So by this way, we have finished our exercise 3.5. Only one exercise is left, that is 3.6. 3.7 is optional, and which we will do in our revision classes. Okay, so you have to solve up to 3.6 only. So one exercise is left. I hope it will complete in two parts. So I hope you have liked or understand the topic. Whatever exercises are left, we will discuss in the next video. Okay, so till then, solve the questions, complete your work, and take care of your health. Okay, children, so have a nice day. Thank you.